Firefighters across the south are learning new procedures for tackling fires in high-rise tower blocks. It follows the deaths of two firefighters in Southampton 5 years ago. A training exercise in Berkshire today aimed to test and validate the new methods before they go live later this year. Nikki Mitchell has the story.
Arriving at a derelict high-rise block in Crowthorne, Berkshire's firefighters have been told there are people trapped inside a burning flat on the fifth floor. The first crew has already gone in. More are on their way.
And I went in the building with breathing apparatus, more hose and equipment to support that initial crew.
The minimum number of crews sent to any high-rise fire has been increased to 6, and the incident commander now has much more flexibility in their choice of tactics inside. All the result of lessons learned from this fire in Southampton. None of the residents were injured, but two firefighters, Jim Shears and Alan Bannon, died trying to tackle the fire.
Clearly, the tragic loss of two firefighters at the Shirley Towers incident in Hampshire in 2010 has really driven the review on a national basis into high-rise incidents. And we've conducted a review with other fire and rescue services in the southeast, so that we're all doing the same thing. We still need to be assertive in our response to these sort of incidents, you know, and clearly we can't be too defensive, but at the same time we've got to balance that with firefighter safety.
Firefighters bring the dummy casualties out to safety. The new procedures learned and validated today will be implemented over the next few months. Nikki Mitchell, BBC South Today.